blackmail.
Okay. That starts the story. And as of now, has you playing dead.
What happened in between?
Rugaria. We toured there. I fell in love with an official. The Rugarian Secret Service threatened to ruin his career and mine.
What did they want?
At first, nothing. Then, they told me to add 3 chords to my last recording.
3 chords to your last recording? Why? What for?
I don't know. But I felt they were going to kill me after I'd done it. I panicked.
What are the names of those 3 chords?
The first one is a G-flat 9 over D. The next is an augmented G7th with a flatted 9th. And the last one is a C6 over B-flat.
With an added 11th and 13th. And you want us to do what with them?
Stick them in your computer.
Mundy, are you crazy?
I want all 3 chords of that music programmed into that computer. In a sane world like this, what's so crazy about that?
Listen to me, Al. If you think that all we've got time to do...
Okay. Okay, if Rugarian security means nothing to you, Devon, then forget it.
What makes you think these chords have anything to do with Rugaria?
What makes you think it has and stick it in the computer?
C6 over B-flat. Give me the computer room fast.
That amazing cry, Marilyn is alive, has raced around the world faster than a teenage fashion gimmick, and the consequences, well, in London, England, not a single ticket has so far been returned to the box office for any scheduled concert during the famed rock group's world tour. This live telecast has been brought to you from the Century Hotel, where Rugaria's president Havos has just arrived.
It is the fulfillment of a dream to be in the United States and talking of peace.
You know something?
What?
That Havos. He might just shame the whole sad world into peace.
You mean that after what their Secret Service did to you, you still like him?
Oh, no, he's a good guy, Rugarian. The government there is split down the middle. Didn't you know that?
Sure.
Liar.
Liar? Me?
Yes, you. You don't know a thing about politics, and you could care less.
That's me. Trust in no one, depend on nothing.
And I know why you act like that.
You do?
Mm-hmm. Now I understand you, Sigmund Freud.
Want to talk about it? I will assume my favorite Sigmund Freud position.
All right. We'll start even. Now, after many hours of careful thought and consideration...
Careful thought and consideration? That's very good. I like that.
I have come to the conclusion that your problem stems from your criminal background.
My criminal background?
And your crooked personality.
My criminal background and my crooked personality. Oh, that's beautiful. I'm glad to know that I'm on the top 10 of your charts.
Okay, you know what I mean. You're the kind of guy who does his own thing.
Like, believing man.
Ain't a believing man. He's a deceiving man. Who'll steal your heart away.
That was was a real big hit for you, wasn't it, Marilyn?
Mm-hmm. But I didn't have you in mind when I wrote it.
And do you now?
More than ever.
Yes.
Hello, Al. This is Devin. We have the computer results for you.
Get that pencil and piece of paper.
Yeah, Devin.
Mr. Jack wants to give them to you personally.
Here it is, Mr. Monday. Don't miss a word. We've run the cards through I-12, our 927, and our 1024. And here is what the world's most sophisticated computer mechanism, working at full emergency capacity on total permutation, at a taxpayer's cost of $87,472.27, has produced. Just for you, Mr. Monday, just for you. Are you ready for this shattering conclusion? Our cars on ice.
Our cars on ice?
That's what it says, Mr. Monday. Our cars on ice.
You gotta be putting me on. Our cars on ice.
I wouldn't waste your time, Mr. Monday. That's what it said. And thanks for keeping Regaria safe.
The three chords mean our cars on ice? Now, what can that have to do with anything that's worth killing for?
Well, as I've said to the fuzz on several occasions, search me.
Our cars on ice. I mean, like, who would go to all the trouble just for something like this?
The Bulgarian Secret Service would go to all that trouble, that's who.
Well, the computer lies. Your friend must have pushed the wrong button.
I don't think so. He's not one of your everyday wrong button pushers. Very meaningful character, Devin is.
Well, this is a meaningless jumble of words.
Let's try to switch the letters around. Maybe we can make something out of it, different words.
When the tube breaks, the acid will fall. Up goes the desk, and Habosh, and all.
Rice on a scour. What have you got?
Or so cure Cain. That can't mean anything.
Croon a cruise.
The music. It's all arranged to be played at the exact time you told me.
Ah, Carol Blitz.
Oh, Mr. President, everything has been prepared for you to work on your speech.
I see you have been busy, too, at your hobby, Carl Blitz.
My small gift, Your Excellency, to welcome you to the United States.
Oh, beautiful. Thank you. And now you will see that I am not disturbed?
Certainly, Mr. President.
Thank you.
You will make certain that the President is not disturbed. Under any circumstances.
Cairo Nurse Company?
Cairo Nurse Company?
Our sonic care. Our sonic care.
Wait a minute, you're onto something. Sonic sound waves.
Enrico Caruso. Enrico Caruso was a singer that could shatter glass by the sonic vibrations in his voice. Enrico Caruso, that's it.
Well, why didn't the computer say so in the first place?
It did. It analyzed the fact that it's capable of shattering a certain type of glass.
Okay. So I helped them break glass with music. Why? What for?
Murder, baby. Murder.
What makes you think President Havos is going to be playing our record? He may not even like our kind of music.
You mean, how do I think they're going to get to him? Bomb and music all together at one time?
Right.
I don't know. That's
how, baby. One less man to pick up. Special pass. President House.
I'm sorry, nobody got it. Suppose you want your present back.
Marilyn?
Yeah.
Marilyn, you have a wrong note on your music in bar 11.
It should
be an E flat instead of an A flat.
Oh, okay.
You could try it.
So it'll go like
right,
that?
Right.
Good.
Perfect. Okay. Yeah. Mark, that's a good work.
Okay.
Right.
Al, so glad you could make it. Look, I really want to thank you. Just like you said, the judge was very understanding.
Well, he must have been a fan. He couldn't have been a music critic.
Oh, wow. Okay, I'm coming. You gonna stay and listen to us record?
Well, I'd like to, but I have to go to India.
Oh, secret stuff, huh?
Yeah, top secret. Some guy with a sitar threatened to play a chord and tumble down the Taj Mahal.
Okay, we were on time for your funeral. At least you can be on time for the session.
I better go.
I'll see you.
Watch the dance party coming up in just a minute, but right now, let's join Casey Kasem for America's Top 10 from Coffee, Stereo TV 20.